royal heartbreak, the private sadness as Meghan Markle and Prince Harry prepare to quit. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry are days away from their final engagement as senior royals, and the couple are reportedly privately sad ahead of their final chapter of royal life. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry will step out for what will be their final engagement as senior royals on Monday, attending the Commonwealth Day service at the request of the Queen. From March 31, Meghan and Harry will no longer be senior members of the royal family, choosing to live privately and strive for financial independence. The Sussexes will live between the UK and Canada as they begin their new lives with young son Archie. However, the split from royal life is bittersweet for Harry and Meghan, according to royal experts. Royal author Katie Nicholl told OK, "This is the end of an era for Harry and Meghan, it's a big deal. While there is a sense of duty and protocol, they are only human at the end of the day, so there will be some nerves. We know Harry is emotional, and while Meghan is made of some pretty tough metal, this trip will be tainted for both of them as they have both been hurt by some of the things that have been written about them since Megxit. The change for Harry will be immense, as he has known nothing but royal life for the majority of his life." However, the Queen has reportedly told her grandson he will always be welcomed back. A royal source told The Sun the Queen had a heart-to-heart with Harry and said, "You are much loved and will always be welcomed back." The source added, "She made it very clear to him that he and Meghan are always able to come back if they change their minds, and she will welcome them with open arms." Hopefully the chat cleared the air. Another sadness came for the couple when they said goodbye to their staff in the UK. Updating their followers with information on their exit from the royal family, Meghan and Harry's website read, "Based on the Duke and Duchess of Sussex's desire to have a reduced role as members of the royal family, it was decided in January that their institutional office would have to be closed, given the primary funding mechanism for this official office at Buckingham Palace is from HRH, the Prince of Wales. The Duke and Duchess shared this news with their team personally in January once they knew of the decision, and have worked closely with their staff to ensure a smooth transition for each of them." Meghan and Harry said they have been actively involved in the transition of staff members, which they say has been, at times, saddening. The statement read, "Over the last month and a half, the Duke and Duchess have remained actively involved in this process, which has understandably been saddening for the Duke and Duchess and their loyal staff, given the closeness of their Royal Highnesses and their dedicated team." However, even if Meghan is feeling sad about being in public again and her family's upcoming shift, Ms. Nicholl says Meghan will not let it be known. She said, "Even if she's feeling uneasy, she won't let it show. She can put on a good front, so we will see plenty of that Megawatt Meghan smile over the coming days." It will be the first time Harry and Meghan will be seen in public with Prince William and Kate, Duchess of Cambridge, since the announcement of the Sussexes' exit. However, this could be awkward as the once Fab Four may not have seen each other much of late, according to the royal expert. Ms. Nicholl said, "In private, I don't think there'll have been a huge amount of contact between the Cambridges and the Sussexes since Harry and Meghan left for Canada. The time difference and the fact that Kate and William are busier than ever at the moment will have made that difficult." However, Kate knows the spotlight is always on them and she doesn't like any stories about the rift. "We're likely to see her embrace Meghan as she has at previous events. Kate is also very fond of Harry, so she won't want him leaving on a sour note, and will do her best to make sure things go as smoothly as possible." Kate and William are currently in Ireland as part of a royal tour and will return to London in time for the Commonwealth Day service. Harry and Meghan to join royal family for last time. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex will join the Queen, the Prince of Wales, the Duchess of Cornwall and the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge at the couple's final official engagement before they quit royal life. Buckingham Palace gave further details of Harry and Meghan's appearance at the annual Commonwealth Day service at Westminster Abbey next week. It will be the first time the Sussexes have appeared with the royal family since their announcement in January and their last as senior royals. Harry and Meghan caused a crisis by announcing they wanted to step back into a dual role, supporting the Queen and earning their own money. But the plan was unworkable and the couple are now dropping their HRH status and stepping away from the monarchy completely from the end of the month. The service in London on Monday will be broadcast live on BBC One and across the BBC World Service. World heavyweight boxing champion and Team GB Olympic gold medalist Anthony Joshua will deliver a reflection, while singers Alexandra Burke and Craig David will perform. Guests among the 2,000-strong congregation will include Prime Minister Boris Johnson, the Commonwealth Secretary-General Baroness Scotland, High Commissioners, ambassadors, faith leaders and more than 800 children and young people.